As Arizona defends its new immigration law in the courts, there's some shocking new video out that appears to show exactly why the state is trying to enforce that law. A group promoting border enforcement using hidden cameras to document what they say are illegal aliens streaming into the country along trails on federal land. Often, they're smuggling guns and drugs and leaving behind tons of trash in sensitive wilderness areas. The mini documentary now available on the web. Joining us now is the producer, Janice Kephart, director of National Security Studies at the Center for Immigration Studies. And on the phone, a man who shot part of that video. We are protecting his identity because he fears retribution by the drug cartels. Janice, first of all, your group is in favor of stepped up enforcement of our borders, right?
That's correct. We are the Center for Immigration Studies, and we are a research think tank in Washington, D.C. I'm the National Security Director. I've been doing border security work for about a dozen years, including my work on the 9/11 Commission. So, yes, we are committed to the issue of border security.
And this is the second time you've put out one of these documentaries that shows what happens along the border using hidden cameras, some pretty interesting stuff. Were you surprised at what you found?
Yes, I was. I actually started receiving this footage anonymously about a year ago based on, you know, my prior work, and there was a storyline there that I had not seen before, and I really thought the American people needed to know it. It's a visual story more than a written story, and so we went the route of a film, and if it hadn't been for the hidden camera footage provided by BorderInvasionPics.com and SecureBorderIntel.org, I would not have been able to make this video.
Let's talk to the photographer now who shot some of this video, and again, we're protecting his identity because there have been threats issued by some of the cartels in Mexico. So you, sir, put one of these cameras out and left it to record whatever passed by, right?
Yes, sir. We have about 8 or 10 cameras working out there all the time. It was just a safe method for us to capture footage. You know, these cameras work for us 24/7, and we can't always be out there. So, and you know, we were very surprised as well.
The number from the documentary, one camera watching one trail over the course of 39 days, captured 739 people streaming by?
That's right. That's right. We had 739 passing by. We checked those numbers multiple times against the hidden camera footage. People were counting each individual to make sure we got that statistic correct. What's more alarming is that there was not one federal law enforcement officer on that trail the entire time.
And for the photographer, we're looking at some footage now that was shot with infrared cameras, so you're able to do this as night as well as during the daytime.
That is correct, and that's actually a thermal camera that's on a scope, so that's not a game camera. And let me just piggyback off Janice's comment about federal agents not working the area. The area I work is an east-west corridor, Interstate 8, which is 80 miles north of the border, and I work very closely with law enforcement, and I always give them a heads up when I go out there. And I've been told several times, not only by boots on the ground, but by supervisory agents as well, not to expect a response because they have no agents to work this area. So keep in mind, this is the area where Pinal County Sheriff Paul Babu was shot. There was 2 other drug runners shot in this area, and there is absolutely no enforcement in this area at the time. And I'm sure the DHS or whoever would love to shoot that accusation down. But anybody can travel this area, and you will not see any Border Patrol currently working this area.
And Janice, to extrapolate the numbers, if this one trail during those 39 days saw 735 people pass by, you figure it's a conduit for maybe 7,000 people a year on one trail.
One trail, and that is with the federal government well aware of the fact that there are thousands of illegal trails over federal lands throughout Arizona. So you extrapolate that number out, you hear the administration saying apprehensions are down. Well, why are those apprehensions down? No federal law enforcement officers are working the federal lands the way they need to be. We absolutely have no idea what the numbers really are.
And to the photographer, you said that you've notified law enforcement when you go into these areas. They're telling you, hey, if you get in trouble, you're on your own. Have you ever encountered some of these coyotes or some of the rougher people on the trail?
We haven't seen anybody with weapons. We have encountered people carrying marijuana up through there. And one time we had About 150 pounds of marijuana sitting on the ground. I notified the federal law enforcement agency, and they did, in fact, tell me they have nobody to come pick these drugs up. So I had to rely on local law enforcement. They need help. They need more people up there. The boots on the ground are young kids. They're ready to go. They want to work it. But they're being told by the higher-ups within the administration to, for some reason, to stay out of that area.
Yeah. Well, a lot of it's sensitive federal wilderness lands, and you saw in some of those pictures some of the trash that's been left behind by some of the illegals as they come across. It's really an eye-opening documentary. We have more information on it available to you on our website if you'd like to. Check foxnews.com. Janice Kepke and the photographer, Janice Kephart, excuse me, Janice Kephart and the photographer, thank you both.